will not tell you how to do it. Why are you doing tax evasion? All right, how my country will get taxed, how it will grow, all right, and then balance discussion you do. Okay, so your institute has done a great thing. I like that they have given lot of case laws, base past case laws, 1985 case laws and all. Okay, why, sir? Just for your knowledge, that you should understand, you must understand what people have done. Whatever discussion I'm doing is not, it's not casual discussion. People have discussed the same thing at Supreme Court level. I hope you understand, if some matter has reached to Supreme Court, how important it has to be. Okay, so they have discussed, we are discussing summary of that. Whatever Supreme Court, High Court have done in past, we are discussing some summary. Okay, so what is the distinction between tax planning, tax avoidance and tax evasion and tax management? Once in CA final, what kind of question came, no? They give different ways. They wrote in description, SSA had done this, SSA had done this, and write down whether it is tax management, tax planning, tax avoidance or tax evasion. Out of this four word, you have to tag one word to that particular activity that they are doing. Okay? So it is a way to reduce tax liability, yes or no? By taking full advantage of advantage provided by the Act. So the advantage is also provided by Act. You are not doing anything wrong. Benefit is given by Act itself and you are taking that benefit. Okay? If you go to mall, they are saying buy three, get one free. You went there with the intention only to buy two shirt. But then you increase your budget. Why? Because if you buy three, then you will get one free. Did you stole, like, did you, are you thieves? Have you taken it unethically? Buy three, get one free. No, no. Legally it is given. If you want that benefit, you take that benefit. You should comply with the condition. Condition was buy three. So in my law, there are certain benefits which are condition in nature. You comply with the conditions and then get the benefit. Hello? Right? One example I can give you. If you start factory, in sales, special economic zone, you get tax exemptions. If you start, you can start factory in special economic zone and outside economic zone also. But if you are a cost accountant and you know that if factory, if you start in special economic zone, then there is a benefit in excise, there is a benefit in custom, there is a benefit in GST, and there is benefit also in income tax, where you will advise your client to start factory? Special economic zone. So there are certain conditions. Comply with the conditions. Take time. Hello? Because if you start factory in Andheri and Jogeshwari, sir, you are not going to get any tax benefit. If you start factory in special economic zone, there will be tax benefit. You are taking benefit which is provided by law. Are you doing any unethical thing? No, you are doing perfectly fine thing. Don't you think your client should appreciate you for this? Yes. Sir, he will appreciate me. How? Sir, by doing this. Shabash. No, I want money. Gandhiji, sir, I studied all these provisions to apply this. I'm applying now. Okay? So you will get paid for it. Tax avoidance. Baad mein aate. Tax evasion. It is legal or illegal?
Illegal.
That much you understand, this is illegal. Okay? What is this tax management? Procedure to comply with? So this is just a procedure. Uska to comparison hai hi nahi. Wo to kya maza aa raha tha unko aise bolne ke liye, tax planning, tax avoidance, tax evasion, tax management. Therefore it has come. Otherwise that does not belong to this table. This table is about these three column. Okay? Second level. Acha, ye kya hai? Tax avoidance kya hai? It is an exercise by which the assessee legally takes advantage of loopholes in law. Ye galat hai. ये कैसा गलत है, लेकिन मोरली गलत है. मोरालिटी भी तो होना चाहिए ना. दैट छोटी लड़की विल टीच यू मोरालिटी एंड ऑल. राधिका हैज टॉट यू नो एथिक्स दैट यू डोंट हैव, यू शुड हैव इन लॉन्गर रन. ओके, टैक्स प्लानिंग इज अ प्रैक्टिस टू फॉलो प्रोविजंस ऑफ लॉ विद इन मोरल फ्रेमवर्क. अच्छा काम कर रहे हो, टालिया. ओके, टैक्स अवॉइडिंग द प्रैक्टिस विदाउट breaking law. So you did not break law, but is it in moral framework? No. Tax evasion is illegal both in script and moral. Morally also incorrect, legally also incorrect. That is just implementation of law. Okay, Object, what is the object? See, to reduce. That is to comply. Here object is common. To reduce tax. Reduce tax by applying law. Reduce tax by applying unfair means, illegal way, okay. And reduce tax by applying law, okay, script only, by applying minimum script. So you are using law. You wanted to read only that much part of law. You don't want to read complete law. Mere benefit ka kitna hai? I look at nahi, okay? I said I will give you break provided we complete section 9. You just listen, I will give you break. Provided ga tel lagane. I'll give you break. Okay sir, bye. It's like that. You will read only the part that you like. You will not read the part of law that you don't like. You will read both, but you will apply only the part that you like. Okay, this is how they do. Approach, you read, it is futuristic, but short-term benefit is there because in longer run, the moment government comes to know, they will apply GAR. Alright, it's not permanent in nature. This is permanent in nature. This is long-term in nature. This is now available in law. Current loophole. How government will override that loophole in ATG? Simply by putting per annum word. It may come in budget 2019. So you take advantage till the time there is a loophole. Government every year they are changing law. Why? Not to overcome this. This they have already overcome. Now they are searching. Like look at the SEC's behavior. There are still some loopholes in law. Current year also they are going to fill some more loopholes in law. Sometime what happens with me, let me tell you. Government amend the law and then I come to know, oh my God, there was a loophole. You understand? So this happens. Benefit generally arise in? This is short term. Benefit do not arise, but it causes penalty and? Kya benefit hai pata hai? Free mein khana. Free mein rehna, free mein khana. Government degi. Government fund karegi aapko. Theek hai? Jail mein. And if you do procedure on time, then you can avoid what? Penalty, interest, prosecution can be avoided. Okay? So, jail mein nahi jana padega, aur kuch nahi. It uses benefits of law. It uses loopholes of law. And it overrules the law. ठीक है मैं दिखाता आपको ठीक है ये लॉ है ऐसे बोलते ना राधिका मिस वगैरह बोलती है ऑलवेज बी इन फोर कॉर्नर्स ऑफ लॉ योर लॉ टीचर विल कम एंड से दिस यू शुड ऑलवेज बी इन फोर कॉर्नर्स ऑफ लॉ यू हैव नेवर सीन दोज फोर कॉर्नर्स टुडे आई एम शोइंग यू दिस इज कॉर्नर 1 कॉर्नर 2 3 एंड 4 ओके सो योर फैक्ट्स शुड बी विद इन द फोर कॉर्नर्स ऑफ लॉ सो दिस इज द लॉ एंड दीज आर द फैक्ट्स ये ठीक है ये ठीक है कि नहीं बताओ ठीक है ना माई फैक्ट्स आर विद इन लॉ नाउ आई विल शो यू इवेजन ओहो फैक्ट इधर है लॉ इधर है इज इट विद इन फोर कॉर्नर्स ऑफ लॉ नहीं सर लॉ उधर रहा फैक्ट इधर है ओके सर अवॉइडेंस बताओ ऐसा होता है अवॉइडेंस दिस इज लॉ दीज आर फैक्ट्स सर इधर से लॉ के अंदर है इधर से लॉ के अंदर है लेकिन सर इधर से बाहर है वो मैं नहीं देखता हमें इतना ही देखता है इधर से लॉ के अंदर है ना एटलीस्ट टू कॉर्नर के अंदर है ओके तो ऐसा कुछ होता है समथिंग लाइक दिस सो बाय लूपहोल्स ओवररूल्स द लॉ इंप्लीमेंट द लॉ प्रैक्टिस दिस इज टैक्स सेविंग दिस इज टैक्स हेजिंग दिस इज टैक्स कंसीलमेंट छुपाना इनकम को छुपाना ठीक है दैट इज एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ओके इट इज डिजायरेबल अच्छा लगता है करने के लिए प्लानिंग है मैंने क्या बोला सबको ऐसा लगना चाहिए अंदर से यस सर वी ऑल्सो वॉन्ट टू बिकम टैक्स प्लानर कि चोर बनना है नहीं क्या बनना है टैक्स प्लानर ये अवॉइडेबल है वहां पे है लॉ में लूपहोल है तो यूज करना जरूरी है अवॉइड भी कर सकते हो ना है लूपहोल अवॉइड करो ना यार ठीक है और ये ऑब्जेक्शनेबल है ऐसे कैसे किया किया ही कैसे गवर्नमेंट बोल सकता है ना ठीक है वो तो इसेंशियल है नहीं करोगे तो मर जाओगे ठीक है ये क्या है मॉरल इन नेचर ये क्या है, इलीगल है, मोरल की बात ही मत करो. मैंने मर्डर किया सर किसी का, मोरली राइट था क्योंकि उसने ब्रेकअप किया था. अरे मोरालिटी की बात ही मत कर, तूने जो कांड किया वो इलीगल है. मोरालिटी के अंदर क्या है कि इमोरालिटी के, वो तो बात को सेकंड स्टेप में आएगा, लेकिन तू जो ने कांड जो किया वो इलीगल है. तो दिस इज इलीगल, दिस इज मोरल एंड दिस इज लीगल बट इमोरल, और वो तो तेरी ड्यूटी है. समझा आपको? एग्जाम में क्या क्वेश्चन बन सकता है, डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन टैक्स अवॉइडेंस एंड टैक्स इवेजन. प्लानिंग और इवेजन आ गया तो बहुत ईजी आंसर, प्लानिंग और मैनेजमेंट आ गया वेरी ईजी. डिफिकल्ट है इन दोनों को लिखना, बिकॉज देयर इज वेरी थीन लाइन डिफरेंस. थोड़ा इधर से उधर प्लानिंग, सॉरी अवॉइडेंस विल बिकम इवेजन, इवेजन थोड़ा उधर से इधर अवॉइडेंस, तो थोड़ी सा ही लाइन है. Okay, very thin line, and therefore you need to study this again and again. Same chart I want in everyone's notebook. Sir, how to make that chart? You download your notes, or you take the photograph, or we will circulate this in your WhatsApp group today. You take it on mail and you circulate and you do it. This is your homework. Okay, I don't have time to allow you to write. Diversion of income and application of income. This also comes sometime, very rare. It used to come in earlier days. Now it doesn't come. But still, because we have reached here, so let us discuss, because at your own you may not understand it. Diversion of income means, say for example, Dilip sir and I, we both teach in this Kalyan Institute, Shetty's Institute. Okay, Dilip sir, me and Anjesh, with all three teach there, alright. Now I am not going there as of now because I am in Jogeshwari. Dilip sir is also not going because his syllabus is over. Okay. My syllabus is like another 3-4 days and it will be over. But Anjesh has syllabus going on. Okay. So my payment and Anjesh payment and Dilip sir's payment, they created 3 envelope. And they gave it to Anjesh. Okay. Who received the income? So let's take example. Mera 1 lakh, Dilip sir ka 2 lakh, or Anjesh ka 3 lakh. 1, 2, 3. Anjesh should pay tax on how many lakhs? उसका खुद का 3 लाख ना, हमारा क्यों नहीं? He received it, but why not our income? Because that is not his money. He is just taking there. He'll come to Jogeshwari. Ram, this is your envelope. Dilip sir, this is your envelope. So he will divert the income. He's not applying. He's not giving me 1 lakh. I should not be saying thank you to Anjesh. Ah, thank you Anjesh, you gave me 1 lakh rupees. Anjesh did not give me 1 lakh. It was my money. He just took from one person and gave it to me. So he took 6 lakh in his hand and then he diverted. So diversion of income is taxable or not taxable? Not taxable. It is written here. Diversion of income is not taxable. Okay. Your papa went to office. Papa earned 1 lakh rupees. Out of 1 lakh rupees, he gave you 10,000 and to your mother 40,000. Now your papa should pay tax on? Because he earned 1 lakh and then he applied that money. That's the application of income. Your papa cannot say this, that see sir, mere paas 85 bachana, I'll pay tax only on 50,000. No sir, that you earned 1 lakh. So application of income is taxable or not taxable? Taxable. Okay, balance thing you can read in detail. Can I go ahead?
Yes.
Tax rates, can we revise it for last time? Okay, for normal individual. No, for super senior citizen, super 80 years up to 5 lakh nil, 5 lakh to 10 lakh 20%, above 10 lakh 30%. Very good. Theek hai. Senior citizen up to 3 lakh nil, 3 lakh to 5 lakh 5%, 5 lakh to 10 lakh 10,000 plus 20% of balance 5 lakh. Okay, and above 10 lakh 1 lakh 10,000, because up to 10 lakh it will be 1,10,000 tax. Yes or no? 10,000 and 1 lakh, it will become 1,10,000, and balance on balance income 30%. We have followed how to do it in all. Okay, and for normal people, this is a basic slab, 2.5 nil, 2.5 to 5.5, then 5 to 10, 12,500 plus 20% of that income, then it will become 1,12,500. So I told you, if it is normal assessed up to 10 lakh, what is the tax amount? 1,12,000. You just have to compute what is there on balance income, 30%. Okay. Rebate, we have discussed. Cases of rebate, we have discussed. Margin relief we discuss. Cases also we discuss. This is the logic. This table is the logic table. Okay. Partnership rate, LLP rate, 30%. Surcharge after 1 crore, 12%. Company, agar turnover 16-17 ka 250 crore, then 25%. Otherwise, by default, 30%. Foreign company, 40%. Surcharge, we have discussed in morning only, 12%, 7%, 5%, 2%. Cess, 4%. Residential status, so study note 1 is done from my side. Yes. Today study note 1 done. Paragraph wise I have covered. Yes. Not left anything for you. Now it is your responsibility to revise. Okay. Introduction done, this section 6.1. Okay. Resident, non-resident, yesterday only we have discussed 182 days, 60 days plus. Hello, 60 days plus 365 days in 4 years. Okay, then this illustration, so we have discussed. Exception, Indian citizen leaves India, foreign employment outside India, Indian citizen leaves India as a crew member of Indian ship. Foreign citizen, but not any random, foreign citizen who is person of Indian origin, comes to India, who is a person of Indian origin? A SESI or his parents or grandparents were born in undivided India. So for them what will happen? 60 days will be cut, replaced by 182 days. So that benefit is given to them. This question we did. Additional condition to become OR. 666. Additional condition to become OR. 730 days out of 7 years and resident for 2 years or more out of 10 years preceding to previous year. There are these illustrations, please do it your own. If you don't get any illustration, then let me know. HUF, management and control, wholly or partly in India, resident, wholly outside India, non-resident. OR, NOR depends on Karta. Okay. Company, Indian company, always resident. Foreign company, POEM in India, resident. Foreign company, POEM outside India, non-resident. Okay. AOP, BY, firm, management and control in India, wholly or partly resident. Wholly outside India, non-resident. OR, NOR, not applicable. Incidence of tax. This also we have discussed. Hello, Indian income. Taxable to all. All means OR, NOR and NR. Indian income means income accrued in India, income received in India, income deemed to be received in India, income deemed to be accrued in India. Deemed to be received is written in section 7 and deemed to be accrued in written 9. So this is how we are reaching to 9 now. Okay. We have to reach to section 9, right? Then only we will start section 9. Foreign income, business control from India will be taxable for OR and NOR. Okay. Then pure foreign income. OR will pay tax because of residence rule. Okay. Morning batch, if you allow me, can I take this question because they haven't done this. Okay. So this is how questions will come in exam. This is your homework question. Regular batch, but allow me to discuss it here and then I will show you one big size question of ICA. Okay, so you will understand it far better way. Ram, my question, provide you details and calculate his total income for assessment year 1920. If Ram is an ordinary resident, if Ram is a non-ordinary resident, and if Ram is a non-resident. So they have created three scenarios. In which scenario Ram will pay highest tax in India? OR. In which case he will pay least amount of taxes? Non-resident. Average NOR. Okay, so let's take. Salary received in India from employer in UK. So accrued in UK but received in India. Indian income? Are Indian income? OR, NOR and NR. So you will write 140 in all three columns. See, this is how. This is how they present the answer. 140, 140. 140. We have created that format. Okay. Now, second, income from tea business in Nepal being controlled from India. Yeah. All right. foreign agriculture income is taxable. First rule is this. Only Indian agriculture income is not taxable. So Nepal is not in India. Although Nepalis are in India, Dilip sir told me yesterday. But Nepal is not in India. Alright, being controlled from India. So control from India. Business in Nepal, control from India. Foreign income, control from India. Foreign income, control from India. Who will pay tax? OR and NOR. NR will never pay tax on foreign income. So this should come in two column. OR, NOR dash. Okay. Next. Interest on company deposit in Canada. So company is in Canada. So source is in Canada. Foreign income, foreign income, foreign income. But one third received in India. They did a mistake. They received one third in India. The amount which is accrued outside India and received in India becomes Indian income. And Indian income is taxable to all. So out of 30,000, one third is Indian income. That means 10,000. So 10,000 over 10,000 NOR and 10,000 NR. Now balance 20,000 is pure foreign income. But still one unfortunate guy will pay tax on that. Over. So see, this is how they present. Okay, 10,000, 10,000, 10,000. One third received in India, two third received outside India. Still it is taxable because of residence rule. We are so much possessive about it. You are earning in Canada, okay, you are mine, you pay tax in India. We are so much in love and care with you, okay. That love will bring that tax, okay. Profit from business in Mumbai, control from UK, ulta. But business is located in India. Finish. Source is located in India. Tree is located in India. Indian income, who will pay tax? All three, okay. Profit from for the year 2002-2003 from a business in Tokyo remitted to India. Foreign remittance are not income. This is not an income, so dash, 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 okay. Income from property in India but received in USA. Property is in
India.
Received in
USA.
Source in India. So
all.
Property in London but received in Canada.
Delhi.
Accrued outside India, received outside India. But still one unfortunate guy will pay tax. OR has to pay tax on global income. Okay. Income from business in Zambia but controlled from Turkey. Foreign business controlled from foreign country. OR will pay tax. OR is unfortunate guy, you know that. See. Delhi. Canada. Hello. This one was left, I guess. London, property is in London but received in?
Delhi.
Bahar hai, property bahar hai, but you received in? Delhi. So all. This is all. This is only OR, OR. Okay. This will be present answer. Income received in India. So the first place should be in India. That is the receipt rule. Income deemed to be received in India. That is section 7. But section 7, you will understand in later part. When allow me to complete at least salary chapter, then you will understand section 7. And income deemed to accrue or arise in India, we have reached to this level. Okay. There are 7 part, 7 clauses to section. And your institute has written it in clause wise. 9.1, 9.2, 9.3. How do we read? Section 9, subsection 1, clause 1. Section 9, subsection 1, clause 2. 9.1 is income from connection in India. I told you Vodafone, okay, directly or
indirectly.
Okay, salary earned in India. You are foreigner, okay. You are Jackie Chan, but you are appointed in India. Now you are working in Jogeshwari. Then? Where is getting salary? Where is his employment is located? Where is mango tree is located? India. Will he pay tax in India? Yes, that is the deemed to accrue in India. He was confused. So we said, don't be confused. Deemed. Maan liya humne. To idhar kam aa raha hai. We don't want legal dispute with you. Okay. Now, foreigner earning in India. So Indian salary. Indian earning in foreign. Then?
Foreign.
At least that should not be taxable. We said even that is taxable in India if it is paid by government of India. Tum log ek employee batao jo India ke bahar hai. Jiska salary government of India deta hai. Government ambassadors, representative of India. Alright. Every nation has one representative office of India. Okay. Foreign ambassadors. They are working in Canada, Australia, USA for India. Who is paying them? Government of
India.
India, their salary is actually accruing in USA. because they are working in USA. But who is paying them salary? Government. हम मान लेते कि इधर है मान लेना सर आई मीन यू से मान लेना कि तू इंडिया में है गवर्नमेंट इज पेइंग यू यार सो दैट फॉरेन एम्बेसडर हैज टू पे टैक्स इन इंडिया ऑन हिज सैलरी ओके इन दिस क्लॉज सैलरी फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट बाय इंडियन सिटीजन फॉर सर्विसेज रेंडर्ड 913 Dividend from Indian company. You are in foreign country. Reliance Energy is giving you dividend. Indian income or foreign income?
Indian
income. Confusion कहाँ है? है ही नहीं. सर वो मैं foreign में. तू किधर भी रहे? Company कहाँ है?
India
में है ना. तो deemed to be accrued in India. Legal dispute चाहिए नहीं. मान लिया. सर ये duster की marker है. ये duster की marker है बोलो. ये deemed duster है. लेकिन सर मार्कर जैसा झगड़ा चाहिए नहीं मुझको अथॉरिटी हूं मैं यहां पे डीम्ड टू बी डस्टर है तो है ठीक है देन ये तीन को मैं अलग से पढ़ाता हूं ठीक है लेकिन है ऐसे कुछ क्लॉजेस चार फर्स्ट पेज वाले हो गए मेरे थ्री सेकेंड पेज वाले आई विल टीच यू इन डिटेल ओके बिकॉज दैट इज कॉम्प्लिकेटेड पहले लेके एक एक लाइन में खत्म हो जाते अरे So this is how you have to make the chart. All right. Start making the chart. Start writing the chart. Allow me to teach one more. Now which focus, which area we are focusing? This side. Okay.
Yes.
1, 2, 3, 4. Can you tell me sections? 911, 912, 913, 914. See, it is easy to remember. 911, 912, 913, 914. In 91 we are having business connection. 911 we are having business connection. 912, 912 we are having services rendered in India. 913 Indian ambassadors working outside India. 914 dividend from Indian company. Okay. If you do this again and again, then you can by heart section, subsection. And clauses, okay, sir. But intermediate, okay. Section is fine. Final, subsection and clauses, okay. Now you take decision whether you want to buy this at intermediate or at final. That is your call, okay. No mandatory force. So allow me to zoom this area. This is the heading, and please understand. Allow me to teach for one more time. Income accruing or arising outside India. So actually income is accruing?
Outside.
Tu bahar hai, tera mango tree udhar hai, lekin uske roots India mein hai. So income is accruing outside India directly or
indirectly.
Through or from. Okay. Any business connection in India. This is the huge concept in CMA final. This is a part of international taxation, okay? Through any business connection in India, either you are having connection in India. So how will you write, you will create three arrows down this. The first arrow is business connection. Second arrow, any a business connection, any property in India. And the third one is transfer of capital asset, okay? So any property in India and transfer of any capital business connection property capital asset business connection property capital asset so you are having business connection in India you are running some business it's on paper it is outside India but you are running through direct or indirect connections in India teri branch hai yahan pe tera agent hai yahan pe all right teri franchise chal rahi hai yahan pe India mein legally you are outside to MACD hai lekin yahan pe franchise hai so we will take tax on that income hello Okay, property, you are foreigner, you have given this building, you are the owner of this rent, your tenant is also in foreign country, alright, he is going to come to India and stay here, agreement signed outside India, rent is paid in dollar, lekin property kahan pe hai, so tax bharna padega na, alright, you sold Indian debentures, Indian equity shares by one non-resident to another non-resident, sab kuch bahar ho raha hai desh ke. हांगकांग ने नीदरलैंड को सेल किया वोडाफोन के शेयर्स यस और नो लेकिन असेट कहाँ पे लोकेटेड है, मेन असेट कहाँ पे लोकेटेड है, डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली कहाँ लोकेटेड है, इंडिया. ओके, दिस इज वन. 9-1 सैलरी अर्न बाय सर्विस रेंडर इन इंडिया.